to have a KYC system fully amenable to meet the needs of digital India. One-stop solution for identity and address updating. A one-stop solution for reconciliation and updating of identity and address of individuals maintained by various government agencies, regulators and regulated entities will be established using DigiLocker service and Aadhaar as foundational identity. Speaker sir, common business identifier for the business establishments required to have a permanent account number, the PAN will be used as the common identifier for all digital systems of specified government agencies. This will bring ease of doing business and it will be facilitated through a legal mandate. For obviating the need for separate submission of same information to different government agencies, a system of unified filing process will be set up. Such filing of information or return in simplified forms on a common portal will be shared with other agencies as per the filer's choice. Vivad Se Vishwas 1, relief for MSMEs. In cases of failure by MSMEs to execute contracts during the COVID period, 95% of the forfeited amount relating to the bid or performance security will be returned to them by government and government undertakings. This will provide relief to the MSMEs. Vivad Se Vishwas 2, settling contractual disputes. To settle contractual disputes of government and government undertakings, wherein arbitral award is under challenge in a court, a voluntary settlement scheme with standardized terms will be introduced. This will be done by offering graded settlement terms depending on pendency level of the dispute. The state support mission of Niti Aayog will be continued for 3 years for our collective efforts towards national priorities. Result-based financing. To better allocate scarce resources for competing development needs, the financing of select schemes will be changed on a pilot basis from input-based to result-based. E-courts. For efficient administration of justice, phase three of the e-courts project will be launched with an outlay of 7,000 crores. FinTech services in India have been facilitated by our digital public infrastructure, including Aadhaar, PM Jan Dhan Yojana, Video, KYC, India Stack, and UPI. To enable more FinTech innovative services, the scope of documents available in DigiLocker for individuals will be expanded. An entity DigiLocker will be set up for the use by MSMEs, large businesses and also charitable trusts. This will be towards storing and sharing documents online securely whenever needed with various authorities, regulators, banks and other business entities. 5G services. 100 labs for developing applications using 5G services will be set up in engineering institutions. To realize a new range of opportunities, business models, and employment potential, the labs will cover, among others, applications such as smart classrooms, precision farming, intelligent transport systems, and healthcare applications. lab-grown diamonds. Lab-grown diamonds is a technology and innovation-driven emerging sector with high employment potential. These environment-friendly diamonds, which have optically and chemically the same properties as natural diamonds. To encourage indigenous production of LGD, lab-grown diamond seeds and machines, and to reduce import dependency, a research and development grant will be provided to one of the IITs for 5 years. To reduce the cost of production, a proposal to review the custom duty on LGD seeds will be indicated in Part B of the speech. I come to the fifth priority, Honorable Speaker, sir, green growth. Honorable Prime Minister has given a vision for life or lifestyle for environment to spur a movement of environmentally conscious lifestyle. India is moving forward firmly for the Panchamrit, the net zero carbon emission by 2070 to usher in green industrial and economic transition. This budget builds on our focus on green growth. The recently launched National Green Hydrogen Mission, with an outlay of 19,700 crores, will facilitate transition of the economy to low carbon intensity, reduce in dependence on fossil fuel imports, and make the country assume technology and market leadership in this sunrise sector. Our target is to reach an annual production of 5 MMT by 2030. Energy transition. This budget provides for 35,000 crores for priority capital investment towards energy transition and net zero objectives and energy security by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. To steer the economy on sustainable development path, battery energy storage systems with capacity of 4,000 MWH will be supported with viability gap funding. A detailed framework for pumped storage projects will also be formulated. Renewable energy evacuation. The interstate transmission system for evacuation and grid integration of 13 gigawatt renewable energy from Ladakh will be constructed with investment of 20,700 crore, including central support of 8,300 crores. Green credit program. For encouraging behavioral change, a green credit program will be notified under the Environment Protection Act. This will incentivize environmentally sustainable and responsive actions by companies, individuals, and local bodies, and help mobilize additional resources for such activities. PM program for restoration, awareness, nourishment, and amelioration of Mother Earth, PM Pranam, will be launched to incentivize states and union territories to promote alternative fertilizers and balanced use of chemical fertilizers. Go Bardhan scheme, 500 new waste-to-wealth plants under Gobardhan, galvanizing organic bio-agro resources done. Gobardhan scheme will be established for promoting circular economy. These will include 200 compressed biogas plants, including 75 plants in urban areas, and 300 community or cluster-based plants at a total investment of 10,000 crores. I will refer to this in Part B also. In due course, a 5% CBG mandate will be introduced for all organizations marketing natural and biogas. For collection of biomass and distribution of biomanure, appropriate fiscal support will also be provided. Bharatiya Prakritik Kheti Bio-Input Resource Centers. Over the next 3 years, we will facilitate 1 crore farmers to adopt natural farming. For this, Honorable Speaker, 10,000 bio-input resource centers will be set up, creating a national-level distributed micro-fertilizer and pesticide manufacturing network. Mishti. Mishti. Building on India's success in afforestation, mangrove initiative for shoreline habitats and tangible incomes, Mishti, will be taken up for mangrove plantation along the coastline and on salt pan lands wherever feasible through convergence between MNREGA, CAMPA fund and other sources. Amrit Dharohar. Wetlands are vital ecosystems which sustain biological diversity. In his latest Mann Ki Baat, the Prime Minister said, now, I quote, now the total number of Ramsar sites in our country has increased to 75, whereas before 2014, there were only 26, unquote. Local communities have always been at the forefront of conservation efforts. The government will promote their unique conservation values through Amrit Dharohar, a scheme that will be implemented over the next 3 years to encourage optimal use of wetlands and enhance biodiversity, carbon stock, ecotourism opportunities, and income generation for local communities. Coastal shipping will be promoted as the energy efficient and low